The Canadian Coast Guard hosted the annual North Atlantic Coast Guard Forum Summit and GUARDEX from September 29th to October 2nd, 2014 in Halifax, Nova Scotia. The North Atlantic Coast Guard Forum is an informal organization made up of Coast Guards, border agencies, and navies from 20 member countries with jurisdictions in the North Atlantic Ocean. The purpose of the organization is to facilitate multilateral cooperation related to maritime safety and security on the North Atlantic Ocean by sharing best practices, exchanging information, and staging an on-water exercise called GUARDEX. Canada's theme was technology, improving efficiency and leading service delivery. This theme focuses on working together on the development and deployment of interoperable technologies. Canada engaged domestic and international partners in GUARDEX 14. The scenario called for a multi-agency, multinational exercise focused on maritime security, search and rescue, and environmental response. The scenario involved a fictitious vessel of interest, the MT Nemesis, which was destined for Canadian waters. Both the maritime security and search and rescue components were held in Mahone Bay, 50 kilometers from Halifax. The environmental response component was conducted in Halifax Harbor. GUARDEX 14 begins with the maritime security component. The objective was to demonstrate Canada's multi-organizational approach to maritime security, which emphasizes cooperation and information sharing. In Canada, no single federal department or agency is responsible for maritime security. Instead, we work with partners to leverage our mandates so we can identify possible threats and respond. Marine Security Operations Centers are staffed by five federal departments and agencies: the Canadian Border Services Agency, the Canadian Coast Guard, the Department of National Defense, the Royal Canadian Mounted Police, and Transport Canada. Their purpose is to enable the partners to work collaboratively to collect and analyze maritime security intelligence. Under GUARDEX 14, scenario intelligence gathered by Canada's maritime security partners reveals that the vessel MT Nemesis is en route to the port of Halifax. The Royal Canadian Mounted Police and the Canada Border Services Agency are interested given the possibility of persons of interest on board who are under suspicion for illegal migrant activity. The Marine Security Operations Center coordinates the tasking of an HC-144A Ocean Sentry medium-range surveillance aircraft from the United States Coast Guard, District 1 in Boston, for the purpose of identifying the vessel. A Transport Canada-8 surveillance aircraft is also tasked to identify the vessel. The Marine Security Operations Center sends an intelligence bulletin on the vessel MT Nemesis to relevant partners. A Canadian Coast Guard vessel is tasked to support the boarding of the MT Nemesis by an emergency response team. Under the scenario, the MT Nemesis now enters Canadian territorial waters. The Canadian Coast Guard ship Sir William Alexander leaves Halifax with the police emergency response team to intercept the vessel. In Mahone Bay, the emergency response team boards the vessel, detains persons of interest, and interviews the crew, who reveal that several migrants were put in life rafts. The Canadian Coast Guard ship G. Petal SC is tasked to escort the MT Nemesis and transport the police and Canada Border Service Agency personnel to Halifax Harbour. The use of interoperable technology is critical in enhancing Canada's marine domain awareness. Marine Security Operations Centers uses an assortment of information and intelligence gathering systems, which are shared amongst national and international partners. These systems include long-range identification tracking, terrestrial and satellite automatic identification systems, vessel monitoring systems, and surveillance assets. The maritime security component of GUARDEX 14 demonstrates the Marine Security Operations Center's multi-organizational approach and how it supports national security. As the maritime security investigation continues, the search and rescue component of GUARDEX 14 begins. The objective of the search and rescue component of GUARDEX 14 is to demonstrate the Canadian Coast Guard's level of readiness and proficiency within the Canadian search and rescue system. The Joint Rescue Coordination Center in Halifax is responsible for the coordination of all search and rescue operations associated with aircraft and marine emergencies in Eastern Canada. The Canadian Coast Guard is responsible for providing the personnel, equipment, and infrastructure to ensure marine search and rescue services are provided. Some of those Coast Guard services include the support provided by the Marine Communications and Traffic Services Centers and the Fleet Regional Operations Center. Under this scenario, Joint Rescue Coordination Centre Halifax receives a call from the Royal Canadian Mounted Police that several people have been thrown overboard. Joint Rescue Coordination Centre Halifax tasks the Sir William Alexander, the G Petal SC, as well as the Canadian Coast Guard ship Sambro to begin searching in the Mahone Bay area. The Sir William Alexander is designated on-scene coordinator. Canadian Forces 413 Squadron from Greenwood sends a CH-149 Cormorant helicopter and C-130 Hercules aircraft. The United States Coast Guard tasks the Cutter Spencer to join their medium-range surveillance aircraft in assisting Canada. Joint Rescue Coordination Centre Halifax tasks the French patrol vessel Fulmer, which is transiting off Halifax. Joint Rescue Coordination Centre Halifax also tasks a Fishery and Oceans Canada surveillance aircraft operated by Provincial Aerospace Limited to provide tactical support to the operation. The Joint Rescue Coordination Centre is a world-class facility with state-of-the-art technological systems. These include a satellite automated information system, search and rescue mission management software, and voice-over internet protocol telephone communications. These technologies enable responders to make informed decisions in coordinating any response to a search and rescue incident. The search and rescue component of GUARDEX 14 demonstrates the Canadian Coast Guard's role in the Joint Rescue Coordination Centre and the high level of readiness and proficiency within the Canadian search and rescue system. The multi-organizational approach to sharing resources, information, and technology ensures an effective and efficient system. At this point, under scenario, the environmental response component of GUARDEX 14 begins as the search and rescue continues. The objective of the environmental response component of GUARDEX 14 is to illustrate the capability of the Canadian Coast Guard's Environmental Response Program and its cooperative approach with domestic and international partners in responding to oil spills within Canadian waters. Under this scenario, the MT Nemesis reports a release of 5 tons of fuel from a crack in the hull while at anchorage in Halifax Harbour. The MT Nemesis refuses to activate their shipboard oil pollution emergency plan, causing the Canadian Coast Guard to assume the role of on-scene command. Partners are also engaged to join the Sir William Alexander and begin the cleanup of the oil spill in Halifax Harbour. The Sir William Alexander deploys an offshore sweep system. The French patrol vessel Fulmar deploys a dispersant spraying system. The Eastern Canada Response Corporation vessel deploys a convergent V-sweep and side-sweep system, and the Queen's Harbour Master's Glen Tug deploys its side-sweep system. The Transport Canada Dash 8 surveillance aircraft is tasked to provide close tactical support to the on-water operations. Their surveillance aircraft's onboard systems feature sophisticated technologies to assist in an emergency response to a spill. The environmental response component of GUARDEX 14 demonstrates the use of specialized vessels and equipment, as well as the ability to deploy in a coordinated and multi-organizational approach. It highlights the strategies and tactics used by the Canadian Coast Guard and its partners to deploy systems to contain and recover floating oil from a spill area in the most effective and efficient manner. In summary, GUARDEX 14 was a successful on-water exercise developed in partnership with key partners. The Canadian Coast Guard would like to thank the following organizations. Our federal partners: Canada Border Services Agency, Department of National Defense, Environment Canada, Fisheries and Oceans Canada, Public Safety Canada, Royal Canadian Mounted Police, and Transport Canada. Our international partners: Secretary General of the Sea, France and United States Coast Guard. Our private and provincial partners: Bridgewater Fire Department, Canadian Coast Guard Auxiliary, Chester Royal Canadian Mounted Police Detachment, Eastern Canada Response Corporation, Lunenburg Fire Department, Lunenburg Ground Search and Rescue, Mahone Bay Fire Department, Province of Nova Scotia's Public Safety and Field Communications, Provincial Aerospace Limited, and the Regional Emergency Management Office, or EMO.